Welcome to tutorial number two. Today we're going to show you how to quickly add a staff member. So at the moment I'm logged in as an admin, and if I have to go to setup, if I have to go to staff, it'll list all the staff. If you notice, I've got this logged in and it shows when I logged in. So I was logged in 7 minutes ago. And if I have to click on this, if I scroll to the bottom, if you notice, I'm an administrator. So an administrator has full permission on the system to create new staff and to delete staff, or, you know, to basically work the system because you are the administrator on the system. So let's get to it. And let's say you go to staff. Okay, let's go start from the beginning. When you log in, you're on your dashboard. Now, there's two ways. You have HR management, where you can click on staff and add a staff. But I prefer quickly adding a staff this way, and I'll show you why. If I click on settings, then I go to staff, and I say new staff. Then I'm just going to quickly put the staff's name in. So let's call it staff one and put there staff STFF surname, and let's give them the email staff one at there. You can put an hourly rate if you want, it will calculate under HR. You can put the person's phone number in. If you have that, if they Facebook, LinkedIn, Skype accounts, if they have, you can create an email signature for them. Now, if the staff member is trusted and working with the company for a while and has a lot of duties, by adding more staff members or is given permission to do a lot, you can make this person an administrator. Means they'll have full access to the entire system, which is not advisable to ever make a staff member an administrator. So what we can do is, before we even set the password, we're gonna go and we're gonna set permissions. I'll come back to this not a staff members in another video. That's more for contractors, where you want to add a contractor to your system and they're not part of your staff. You can click that, but I'll show you in detail more. So let's go with this staff member called staff one. We go to permissions, and then you go through all the permissions, what they can and can't do. So if this person is handling contracts, now we can view global, simply means all the contracts on the system, or view they own means only clients assigned to the staff member. So I would want this staff number one to have full access because they need to handle all the contracts, and then they must be able to create and edit clients' contracts, but I'm making them not to delete contracts. So they cannot delete any contracts without, because I'm an administrator and they are not an administrator, so I'm not giving them permission to delete. They can view credit notes, but they cannot create credit notes because that'll be the accounting department. So this person can view credit notes. So this person also deals with new customers that comes in for them to data capture. So I'm going to give them permission to view customers, create customers, and edit customers. So any new customer, they can come. Edit is if a phone number changes or a physical address changes. So the staff member number one will have permission to, but again, not to delete customers. Okay, email templates, I will leave it blank. I'll explain to you what email says, email templates are. So estimates, basically, if you, this staff member now is creating quotations for clients. So I'm going to say yes, we can create and edit a quote, right? Now, when you say global, it's basically all the clients, whether there's a client assigned to the staff member or not. But just say you have departments where certain clients is handled by certain individuals only, then you say own and you assign that client to the staff member. But in this case, this staff member will be handling anyone's client, you know, so I would say global. The staff member does not handle expenses or deal with anything to do with expenses, but the staff member here does handle invoices. So they can create invoices overall, not just their own. When I say own again, it's customers assigned to the staff member. And I'll show you that when we're creating customers. They can create and they can edit invoices, but they cannot delete an invoice. So this gives the company a little bit of security that no invoices will be deleted. And I'll show you about editing an invoice. The system tracks every single, that's why this staff member, when they log into the system, it'll track all the activities that the staff member is working on. Whether an invoice was created by the staff member or even an edit was done on an invoice. So you can go back and when company managers or owners always ask staff, like, own up, who did whatever, you know, why was that invoice changed or deleted or whatever, and it's always, we don't know who did it stories. So with this system, it tracks individual transactions done by each staff member, and I'll show you that under utilities, and we can do that. So Items is items you sold or selling on the system. They can create and edit items. Knowledge base is a very nice thing to have for customers. They can create knowledge base. They won't be handling payments. That'll be the cashier side who will receive payments. They only create invoices. So they're not allowed to knock off payments because maybe the boss receives proof of payments that customers paid by EFT or the finance department, they will be in charge of that. So this staff member is not in charge of knocking off payments. Projects, yes, I would think all staff members can create and edit projects. Proposals, yes, and edit proposals. They can also view reports. Staff roles, they can view, but they cannot create new staff or change or edit any staff roles. Settings, they can view any settings. Again, they can view other staff members on the system. If you're doing subscriptions, they can, but this company does not do subscriptions. And we've got task. It's nice to each staff member to create tasks for themselves. Task checklist. Leads, they can view products and create products, add products to the system. They can do inventory and edit the inventory. But notice I'm not ticking delete here because I don't want them to delete inventory of the system. Even though the system tracks it, we only the certain trusted staff members must be given certain privileges. Chat module is this. And if you can see, if I click on that, at the moment there's only one staff member, so nothing happens. So I'm going to grant chat module access. HR, they can view HR management. Your HR manager will have full access to all of this. I would also say don't allow them to delete because I can show you how we can block off certain staff members. Project roadmap, all staff should be there. Omni sales, they can view for now because this staff member won't be handling Omni sales. I'll explain what Omni sales is. Purchases, the staff member will not be handling any purchases because that will be the purchase department. Goals is straightforward, their own personal goals. Mind map, I think all staff members can create and edit mind maps. Surveys, they can do surveys, they can create surveys with customers because this staff member, they can view the commission or not. Commission receipt, leave that blank, you don't have to. Staff, you don't have to. Commission program, they're not part of the commission program. This staff is a basic salary, doesn't earn commission because they don't do they're not reps on the road. And they can create appointments. The staff member can create and edit appointments. And then when you're happy with all the permissions that this staff member is, that you've given to this staff member, then you go here under profile and then we set a password. In this case, I'm just going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we preview that, and I'm going to click save. And that's it. That is now a new staff member. So if I have to click on staff, now I'll have two staff. The boss, we had this one. And then we've got staff one, and staff surname is the surname. Now we can go and view this again and edit. So I'm going to take out the word staff surname because I just, there's an edit, and then it's just staff name. We can just put staff one and surname is the staff surname. So let's just get rid of that. We can move this around there, and I'm going to save that. And notice it changed there. And if I go back here, and that's it, staff one, and that's their surname. Now let's X this. Let's go to HR and let's go to staff. Now, the reason I don't like going in through creating a staff this way through the HR department, because this is extensive to create a staff. If you look at it, they want birthplace, birth date, hometown, sex, male and female. So if you have an HR department and you need to data capture this stuff extensively, then you go through the HR department. And you can see email signatures, other information, and it also has, you know, two-factor authentication, where when this staff member logs in, they must get a verification email, confirm that, and then they'll be able to log in. And then permissions works the same. You can give all the permissions that you need to the staff member. And that's the long way, and I just did the short way now. So that's the two ways of adding a staff member. So if you want to go back to setup, let's go back to staff. To add a third staff member, you just go new staff member and you just repeat the process. Now, if the staff member leaves, or if the staff member, you know, has some issue with the company, because some companies do have these problems, and you don't want the staff member to log in from outside the company, because it's cloud-based software, this staff member can log in from anywhere and do their work. Now, if there's lockdowns coming up, hopefully not, or if for some reason this staff member has to work from home or anywhere else in the country or from another branch, they can log in from anywhere. But for whatever reason, you as the manager or the owner of the company don't want the staff member to log in, all you got to do is come to the staff section and deactivate that staff. So this person now will not be, as long as this is deactivated, this person will not be able to log in no matter what. So what I'm going to do is, now I'm going to log out. Okay, let's activate this person again. If you see, now as an admin, I'm exposed to a lot of stuff on here, right? So I'm going to log out. And then I'm going to log in as that staff member. So staff1@.co.za. And then the password was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to say remember. If the staff member is this their personal computer or company computer that's assigned to them, it's advisable for them to do this. But if they are logging in from anywhere, you should tell them not to ever remember the password, because you don't want anyone else logging in. So I'm going to say log in. And now I'm logged in as the staff member. See, it says welcome staff one. If the person's name was there, then it would show that person's name. So if you can see now, it's less items here because I haven't given that much permission to this person. So if you see now, I'm this person and I can now, so I'm going to send a test message to the boss, right? And then from here, when I log in now as the boss, you'll be able to get that message. Now, this is the little panel on the top. So if I click on this, I can view my profile as the staff and I can upload my photograph. So other staff members, so if you have 20, 30 people working for you, then you know it's easy to identify them by their photograph. So this is my own profile. I can add a photograph here. I can view my notifications and check what projects I'm working on, or I can go to the dashboard. And because I can do invoices, I'm get to see certain things on the dashboard and whatever. So I'm logged in as that staff, new staff member, and that's about it. So I'm going to work on the next video, which we're going to now add a customer next, and then from there we'll move down the line. Thank you, and hope to see you in the next video.